متحدثنا الآن هو المهندس صبحي بترجي، الرئيس والعضو المنتدب لمجموعة مستشفيات السعودي الألماني بالمملكة العربية السعودية، وهو كذلك رئيس اللجنة الوطنية للرعاية الصحية في مجلس الغرف السعودية. يحمل المهندس صبحي بترجي الماجستير في الهندسة الكهربائية من جامعة كولورادو بالولايات المتحدة، وله مشاركات عديدة في مؤسسات خيرية ونفع عام. سيقدم لنا المهندس صبحي بترجي ماذا يستطيع القطاع الخاص تقديمه.
السلام عليكم. الحمد لله الذي هدانا لهذا وما كنا نهتدي لو هدانا الله. Imagine being the last speaker after a heavy lunch, the lunch that you all have enjoyed. And it's now my duty to wake you up, and it's my duty also to tell you how it should be done. Please join me in giving yourself a hand for listening to me. Now that you are awake, I can start what I'm up here to say. I'm sure you are all bored with these slides. Yeah, most of us are speaking the same language, telling you the same figures, the same population growth, the same difficulties, the same story. I've been listening to this now for 2 days. Most of these slides are similar to what you have heard, so I'm not going to repeat them. I'll just skip through them very quickly, and then I'll go directly to the meat, private sector like, take-home value, and I'm really proud that I'm standing here and telling you how we think it should be done. The overview. The current scenario, this is an overview of my presentation. The current scenario in Saudi, in the health sector in the Middle East, opportunities and challenges, you have heard that. Creative, conducive environment, you have heard that. But the last one or two, this is what I will stress on today. Before I start, I want you to know that Saudi Arabia is a really nice place. It has a huge potential. In healthcare, we are unique, in my opinion, unique in the world, بدون أي مبالغة, without exaggeration. Unique because in 30 years ago, for a developing country to decide to give soft loans to the private sector in healthcare, that's unique. I have not heard it anywhere in the world. To give soft loans to the private sector in healthcare. That's why I'm standing in front of you today. Because of that, even though nowadays I think this money is peanuts, nowadays, because we have grown so big, but it was at that time very essential. It's a very good move. Imagine if they have done that for higher education. We would not have been having all these problems that we have today with Saudization. If the government has given soft loans to higher education 30 years ago, it would have been a different story. It would have been 25% of the higher education will be given by the private sector, same as 25% of the healthcare services are now being done by the private sector. So, because of these soft loans, 16 years repayment, 4 years grace period, interest free. Fantastic. This makes the project at that time feasible from day one. So because of those, such brand have evolved, such like Saudi German Hospital. And I can say with modesty, to give an example, that the services that my group gives is larger than one or two small Gulf countries put together. That's how big the private sector can grow if given the opportunity. So current scenario, you've heard it. I'm not going to repeat it. What's the situation? What is the government hospital situation? Rising healthcare cost, all that. I'm not going to repeat it again. How the private sector can sustain a business model, you know that. I'm not going to repeat it again. What privatization does here and anywhere in the whole world, I'm not going to repeat that. The impact and challenges of WTO, you have heard it from previous speakers, so I'm not going to do that. That is one of the problems when you come the last speaker. Everybody has spoken about the whole, everything you have said. So it is really a little bit difficult how to, but I still have something that nobody has touched. The usual challenges of our industry being fragmented, organized capital is shying away. You know, these are very heavy investment projects. So they rather invest now on the speculation on the stock market than invest in a hospital that will give return in 5 years or 10 years. So you know the story. The opportunities are tremendous. This is one of the things that I want to speak about. All of you, for non-Saudis or for our international visitors, to let you know how the amount of liquidity in the market. New IPOs are oversubscribed 150 times. That should tell you how much money is available in the stock market. Participation of financial institutions, for example, the Islamic Development Bank, is a, once approached properly, is an equity partner in an organization like ours. International financial institutions are interested in partnership, but you should provide the economic model for that and the efficiency of management so to have them on board. Public-private partnership, this is one of the things I will stress on later on. Mandatory insurance, you know about it. Demand exceeds supply, we all know about it. Opportunities, more opportunities. We have not yet spoken about, you know, in healthcare, for example, in Saudi. We are talking about general hospitals with some tertiary care. Imagine if you build an open heart pediatric hospital in Riyadh. Huge potential. If I talk about leveraging technology, I have competitors here listening to me, so I'm not going to talk about that. Private sector mentality. They have chosen Tariq Gassabi to be my chairman. This guy is a dallah, he's a competitor, he's across the street from me. And they expect me to tell him how to do it. We have not yet even touched lifestyle management, obesity, hundreds of rehabilitation. These are the models that I want to talk about. I'm writing a book called How to Do Business with the Poor, based on my experience in Yemen. Me and my brother, Dr. Baterji, we decided to go to Yemen. We felt that Allah has blessed us with wealth and knowledge, underline knowledge. And these, our poor neighbors, our Muslim brothers, 17% of them, of their newborn, die of diarrhea. So, yaakhi, after all, yani, في جنة وفي نار ولا لا. Is that Fijan of Inar? Okay, well, let's go to help. So we started to go there based on let's at least break even. And we wanted to create a model that is really different. A tertiary care hospital, a Mayo Clinic of the African Horn to cater for the poor. Miskin, the poor are really poor. So when we went there on our own, we had a really difficult time, and we started, and many people thought that it's not going to work. But when that building started to come up, a really tertiary care building, same quality as the building that we have in Riyadh, people start to look at us. This is an example of creating wealth out of social cause. We expected that this hospital might be the worst performing hospital that we will have. Then the Yemeni government said, oh, these people, they're really serious. So they handed us a check of $22 million as equity share. Then the Islamic Development Bank said, oh, these people are really serious. So they gave us an $8 million check. Now another banker is thinking of giving us another $10 million as a loan to finance. We have now another international investor. The government said, and this is the dressing over the cake, I'm spending $150 to $200 million abroad. No more. Everybody goes to this hospital first. So we believe that this hospital will be the most profitable hospital in the group now. That is creating wealth out of social cause. That will be the basis of my book, How to Do Business with the Poor. The poor is not poor, really. He's confused. He's unorganized and he's uneducated. There is no country in the world has zero, zilch resources. Everybody has resources. So it is just how to address these resources and how to manage these resources and how to educate them how to use these resources. That is one model. This is the hospital now. Inshallah, it will be open in December, January maybe. No problem. February, no problem. Electricity company there, we have a problem with it. They cannot plan well. So I am digging a 16-kilometer trench inside Sana'a to put the 33 kV cable, which I purchased myself, with an earthquake zone number 3 in Yemen, with sometimes gun shooting on the site.
3 minutes, Mohandas Sabhi.
How much?
3 minutes.
Three more minutes. But yet still, those people are appreciative of what we are doing, because it will save a life. Even the minister, the president of the country is closely monitoring the project. This, inshallah, you will see it. We have another model in Hail, north of. Who would want to build a tertiary care hospital in Hail? I would. It's a remote city, 300,000 population at the most. But I have now developed that model with the participation of 58 businessmen and women from Hail, with 50,000 riyal. Some of them, a woman participated as equity partner of 50,000 riyal as an equity partner in the hospital, 50,000 riyals. I'm building a $50 million hospital there with the Islamic Development Bank as equity shareholder, with Sultan Charity Organization as a 10% equity shareholder, Islamic Development Bank 20% equity shareholder, Saudi Yemen Hospital 40% equity shareholder, 50 million riyal free interest loan from the government. And training for creating jobs, giving tertiary care in Hail. Yani what I'm trying to say is there is nothing impossible for the private sector. The ground is set, particularly in Saudi Arabia, but you have to really know how to address. That's why I'm sharing this information with you today. Recommendations. There's hundreds of things to be done. I'm going to limit it to one. And by the way, enough talking, ya jama'ah. This, we've been talking for the past 3-4 years. Who is responsible for this event? It's about time that somebody take these recommendations and put them in action. We're tired of talking and repeating what we are saying. Enough is enough. My single recommendation is this private sector in healthcare and education cannot and will not be able to flourish with the size the country is now about. We are now a bigger country. We are growing. In Jeddah, for example, we used to have 2 delivery rooms in our Jeddah hospital. Today we have 13, almost 1 extra delivery room per year. These are, Saudis are growing like rabbits, mashallah, tabarakallah. So how are we going, how are we addressing these issues? Everybody, why do you think the endowment fund tomorrow are happening? They want money. The government itself is asking for money to finance the cancer center as in King Faisal Specialist Hospital. So unless we allow the private sector, unless the government restructures the finance, one recommendation, change the name of Saudi Industrial Fund, which is responsible for giving soft loans to the industry. They have created fantastic industries over the past 30 years through this fund. Call this fund Saudi Economic Development Funds. Instead of it, just change one letter from SIDF to SEDF. And since it's economic development, and put the human capital under it. The human capital loans, which is healthcare and private sector, is now being done by the Ministry of Finance. إدارة القروض والإعانات. We don't want إعانات. We want loans. We want 50% loans, same like the other industries, to invest in the most important capital, which is humans. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Engineer Sobhi. بس لدعم مقولة أو وجهة نظر المهندس صبحي في أن القطاع الخاص يستطيع أن يقدم شيئا. الدكتور عبد الرحمن الحميضي أشار إلى أن كلفة ما عربي وإنجليزي كل شيء. فأشار أن كلفة there is a translation. أن كلفة الشخص عندما وزع الميزانية للخدمات الصحية على السكان هي 531 دولار، وهي أغلى من قسط التأمين المعمول به الآن في السعودية. فلو أعطي هذا التأمين صحي للمواطنين سيكون أوفر للدولة، كذلك ما أشار له بالنسبة للتعليم العالي. سنفتح الباب الآن للأسئلة والحوار، ونبدأ بالأخوات في القسم النسائي. تفضل.
دكتور عصبة من مستشفى باكدو. دكتور عرفان. أوكي. As I understood from this conference, is the aim to involve the and encourage the involvement of the private investors in healthcare. Investors has to gain economic profit, and applying all the standards, qualities, and all this need money. In the same time, when we apply the insurance, we are increasing the bargaining power of the insurance companies. So how we can not affect the price? How can this not affect the price?
Was it addressed to me?
Was the question addressed to me?
No, who and
KP. It's addressed to Mr. Lindsay.
Lindsay, okay.
How we can have a high quality healthcare, private healthcare, and have a high bargaining power of our customers, which is the insurance company, and have suitable price that the investors still have economic profit.
Yeah, I will answer the question if you allow me.
If we can jointly do it. After you.
Yeah, please.
The first thing is, in response to your question, in my presentation, which unfortunately I was unable to show all the slides, I agree with you that there is risk in pursuit of full privatization. And yes, you are right that the providers who are in the private sector and the insurers both need to make their costs and make a return on their investment and make a profit for their shareholders. Is it possible for the price to be maintained and quality to be maintained? Certainly, I believe in the short to medium term that is definitely possible. If you're moving from a system where there is inefficiency, waste of money, and low quality, and you provide a competitive environment where the purchasing is done based on price, volume, and quality, i.e. the insurers are looking to buy that, I think there is the capacity to reduce cost and increase quality and give a better deal for consumers. There is the risk, however, in the long term, as has been the case, say, for example, in a full market, free market situation like in the United States, where whilst there was an initial increase in quality, to some degree that is now decreased at some hospitals, not in all hospitals, and there are pricing issues which are affecting access and, as mentioned in the last Hillary Clinton paper, about 45 million Americans don't have access to health care. Has that answered your question?
Yeah, okay.
About the bargaining power of insurance company. We will have a high bargaining power of insurance company. How we can compete with that?
How we can
do that?
It depends on whether there's going to be market failure or not. If there are and the demand and supply side of things, if there are numerous entities all offering a service at a price and quality, then in terms of the insurance company wishing to purchase the service, therefore it is able to bargain and trade off and seek the best deal for its insured members.
Yeah, thank you, Lizzie. Julian Subhi, you want to comment on that question?
I'm a personally believer in supply and demand, even for healthcare. And I believe that once you balance these two, you will have quality and you will have a low price. Simple as that. And I'm willing to test that model in Saudi Arabia. And I want to add, I'm willing to challenge that there is not a single country in the whole world that has as extensive, I will not say as extensive, as a long experience in the private sector healthcare like Saudi Arabia. It is 30 years old. The private sector has been allowed since more than 30 years to practice healthcare in Saudi Arabia.
Thank you. Another question from the other side. Al-Akhwat fil al-Qasm al-Akhar.
Assalamu alaikum. Nira Mishkas, Mjiri Tijazira. أنا تمنيت أنه يكون في أحد من وزارة الصحة لأن أنا عندي تعليق واستفسار في نفس الوقت. إحنا لا زال نعاني من ارتفاع تكاليف المستشفيات الخاصة عندنا إحنا. يعني إحنا ما ننكر أنه في نوعية من المستشفيات لها جودة عالية وأجهزة حديثة، لكن هناك تكاليف مالية جدا يعني ممكن نقول خيالية. يعني أنا أتمنى أنه المهندس صبحي يجاوبنا على هذا السؤال بحكم أنه صاحب مستشفى خاص، أنه ما قولك في المستشفيات اللي تبالغ في التكاليف أحيانا ممكن توصل لـ2 مليون. يعني قبل أسبوعين أحد المستشفيات الخاصة طلبت من شخص وضع تأمين مقداره 2 مليون. أيضا سيدة عمل لها عملية قسطرة في القلب، فلما ذهبت مركز أحد المراكز الخاصة بالقلب آخر اكتشفوا أنه أصلا هي ما تعاني من مرض القلب. فأرجو أنه يكون وزارة الصحة تضع سقف لهذه التكلفة المالية الغير طبيعية عندنا احنا خاصة بالسعودية. خلينا نتكلم بكل صراحة، احنا نطالب المرضى او المستشفيات الخاصة تطالب المرضى بتكاليف ووضع تأمينات يعني توصل احيانا 200 و300 الف واحيانا 20 الف يمكن مدة ايام قليلة، وفي المقابل احيانا تكون الخدمات الطبية يعني ما تجي امامها 1% من هذه امام الخدمة المالية. فالواجهة لبعض المستشفيات الخاصة هي دفع فقط، يعني كيف يستنزفون جيب المريض فقط وليس كيف يعالجونه.
شكرا.
يا أختي، هذه الهيلث كير is an expensive service. أول حاجة إحنا ناس in the business for 20 years. The cheapest health care service is in Saudi Arabia in the whole region, and the cheapest and the best buy for the price. You go to Europe and you go to anywhere in the region, we are at least 1/4 of the cost. Many of the hospitals here are losing money. Many. I have seen many balance sheets of local hospitals. Many are losing money. The hospitals are the most inefficient organizations. They have great number of losses. Please don't be misled. These invoices are not really expensive. Go abroad and see. You will see what is the real cost there.
نعم، بعد ممكن أن أضيف، هو طبعا كلنا لا يوافق على أي تلاعب في الفواتير، ولا أحد يرضى ذلك. وهنا يأتي يعني دور وزارة الصحة عندما تتفرغ الوزارة للتقنين والرقابة وضبط الجودة سيكون فعالية. طبعا اللي تفضلت فيها الأخت أعتقد أنها يعني هذه ممارسات، طبعا إذا كانت مثل ما تقول أن ما عندها قلب وأعطها حملها فاتورة فهي ممارسات خاطئة ويجب إيقافها. لكن أخشى أن هذه مثل من يعني يشلع الشوك، التقاط لي. طبعا احنا لا يعني لا نزكي العاملين في القطاع الصحي الخاص، ممكن ان يصدر منهم اخطاء مثل ما يصدر من اي بشر، لكن اعتقد ان هذه حالات يعني شاذة ومنبوذة وغير مقبولة. وفي المقابل يجب أن نأخذ الخدمات اللي قدمها القطاع الخاص لسد الفجوة في الخدمة. يعني نرجو أن نكون متعاودين. في أسئلة أخرى من صالة الرجال؟ تفضل. أوكي، في أحد عنده سؤال هنا؟ تفضل باختصار السؤال.
باختصار، السلام عليكم. عبد الله الزهراني، طبعا رجل اعمال في تمويل الخدمات الطبيه. في واحد فهمها قبل شوي تقييم المستشفيات، انا في تقديم خدمات طبيه فقط للمستشفيات في اللاب. سؤالي للمهندس صبحي، ما هي الفجوات الحقيقيه بين القطاع العام والقطاع الخاص في عدم التاقلم الاقتصادي الصحي حتى الان؟ انا تعمدت ان اقول فجوات وليس فجوه. شكرا.
سعيد سؤالك مرة ثانية، الفجوات الحقيقية ايش؟ في عدم ايش؟
ما هي الفجوات الحقيقية بين القطاع العام والقطاع الخاص في عدم التأقلم الاقتصادي الصحي حتى الآن؟ يعني نجد فجوات ما بين القطاع العام والقطاع الخاص. يعني أضرب مثل بسيط، لو طبيب مثلا برز في قطاع عام، أنا كقطاع خاص أجي أعرض على الطبيب هذا نوع معين من المبلغ من المال فأخذه من القطاع العام ووضعه في القطاع الخاص، وهذه من بعض المشاكل الموجودة الحقيقية. يعني
يا أخي، أنا أعتقد الوزارة يجب أن I think that the ministry، أكلمك بالعربي، أعتقد أن الوزارة يجب أن تعيد تقييم موقفها، أو مش تعيد تقييم، توضح موقفها من ناحية الخدمات الصحية. الوزارة عندها استراتيجيك بلان، عندها خطة استراتيجية معلنة، وهو الخروج من الخدمات الطبية بكاملها في خلال 20 عام مثلا. لكن الآن الوزارة بتقدم الخدمات بمقابل وبتدخل في القطاع الخاص، فهذا مشكل ربكة في الاقتصاد الصحة. والآن عندهم مناقشات مع البنك الدولي ومع هيئة الاستثمار ويقولوا لهم يا جماعة get off the private sector. هذه خدمات يجب أن تقدمها القطاع الخاص، ما تقدمها الجهات الحكومية.
شكرا. أسئلة أخرى؟
Excuse me, we have two questions.
صالة النساء في صالة ثانية، تفضلي.
السلام عليكم. Engineer Batorji, based on your interest in investing in human resources, I would like to ask how can we utilize your respective group resources to upgrade the level of nursing profession from diploma level to bachelor degree and higher education?
Yeah, we're doing that. Our group now has established four diploma centers, not only for nursing, for health sciences, x-ray, lab, medical records, hospital management. We have 600 students in them. For Dalla has also had made, they have a center. Not only this, we are building the largest medical university in the whole Middle East in the private sector. This is a 250 million riyal institution in Jeddah with for 4,000 students. It's 50% complete. It's a very huge project, big project, a monument. It has 9 colleges in it. Medicine and pharmacy and dental and health sciences, x-ray, lab, physiotherapy. It has health informatics, health management, and so on. So there's plenty to be done in there.
Yes, please.
Assalamu alaikum. I'm Dr. Badriya. Just I want to ask the engineer Subhi Patelji, I do appreciate your effort in helping nearby countries, but don't you share with me that the concept of building human capacity of these countries and improving health education among public is more important than building infrastructure things? Are we going to repeat the same mistakes in the private as in the government sector? Thank you.
No, we are not making a mistake. We are investing in both areas. Infrastructure, there is no infrastructure in Yemen at all. I am an Arab, I'm a Muslim Arab. Yemen is my country too. And they deserve to live. They will take me to Jannah too. Yes, أَيَأْتِي أَحَدُنَا شَهْوَةُ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ يَكُونَ لَهُ فِيهَا أَجْرٌ. نعم, we do business and we go to heaven too. We create jobs and we go to heavens and we get paid for it. We are building infrastructure too. We are building in human capital. We are building in universities and educational institutes here too, same time.
شكرا. تعقيب دكتور؟ تفضل.
الحقيقة هو إيضاح محمد العمر مستشفى الملك فيصل التخصصي. المهندس صبحي بترجي الله يجزيه خير ويجمعنا وياه في الجنة. في حماس وفي البرزنتيشن قال انه المستشفى الملك فيصل التخصصي مسوي الوقف على اساس انه يبني مركز السرطان عنده. الحقيقه هذا في مخالفه للواقع وللهدف من اقامه اليوم الكامل عن الوقف الصحي. الوقف الصحي باشمهندس ممكن بكره ان شاء الله تعالى يعالج المرضى عندك في مستشفياتك. فهو الحقيقه للعموم والمستشفى المكفز التخصص ما يهدف الى انه يحصل عليه شخصيا.
I have to answer to this, please. One answer and I reply to this. This is not my intention. If I make I'm sorry if I made the wrong statement. It is not really meant to be like that. It's meant that my objective of the statement is that healthcare is rising cost, and for that we have to look for extra revenues. As simple as that. It is not really meant to be like that. And I will withdraw my statement وحط عليها تحت خطوط.
Okay.
Thank you.
تفضل.
I think Mr. Sales different from the Pepsi time now, which the discussion you're seeing is completely different 20 years ago and what we're seeing now. Actually, my question actually to Dr. Abdulrahman Al-Hamaili. I'm just wondering, I'm really pleased I hear this lecture from somebody representing the Ministry of Health. I'm Dr. Al-Turki. I'm from Adama Hospital, Dermatology and Plastic Surgery. I'm just really, truly pleased to hear this from the side of the government. I'm just wondering, this is personal views or it's the view of the Ministry of Health?
First of all, I'm not. I do not work now at the Ministry of Health. I have departed the Ministry of Health for a year and a half ago. The presentation is a personal view. It is readings that I have done myself, and also speculations of the future that I have calculated myself of the figures that I have collected.
Yes. Thank you.
Thank you. Fadal.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم دكتور موفق المنصوري اسيستنت ميديكال دايركتور مستقبل هوسبيتال جده اكشوالي ماي كويشن از ادريس تو دكتور الحميدي دو وي نيد تو انفست مور ان هوسبيتالز اند وات اباوت ذا سبيشال ان اربن اريا اند وات اباوت بولي كلينكس Do we need to have more organized polyclinics and to establish a good system for referral, especially nowadays when we are talking about the insurance? Thank you.
Well, I think that always the decision maker of the investor, he's the one who should do his own studies about the feasibility of the project. Some may require hospitals, some may require tertiary hospitals, some may require small hospitals, some may require polyclinic. I think that's to give a rational answer. It depends on the location. It depends whether you're a rural or urban area, what is the population, what is the aging of the population. I think this is the decision of the investor. Yet, I think with the factors that are involved, the size of the investment, the partners, you know, the style, then also the technology involved. It seems to me that polyclinic obviously is less expensive than hospitals. Usually they have multifaceted specialization where you could open them, you could serve, you know, higher patients, and it is similar to outpatient clinics.
معلش دكتور هو بس استفسار بسيط
تفضلي
انه دائما احنا نتكلم عن التقدم الطبي عندنا في المملكه لكن نلاحظ انه في بعض الاطباء عندنا ما راح احدد اسماء اكيد راح يعرفونهم انهم عندما يمرضون يتوجهون الى خارج المملكه لتلقي العلاج فهل يعني هذا انه عدم ثقه في الطبيب السعودي رغم ان احنا وصلنا للعالميه واحنا ما نحتاج الضبابه الا على اقربها لفصل التوائب يعني احنا عملنا 9 عمليات في تقريبا اكثرها في اوقات متقاربه من بينها عمليه عجز اطباء كثيرين في العالم انهم يفصلوها او غضوا البصر عن عمليه الفصل خوف على حياه الاطفال لكن الاطباء السعوديين هنا استطاعوا فصلهم لكن لا زال هناك عدم ثقه من بعض الاطباء او بعض المسؤولين انهم يجرون عمليات خارج المملكه يعني فما ادري
واضح النقطه انا يعني اتبرع بالجواب هو طبعا في الطب المريض يبحث عن المتخصص في حالته او في عمليته طبعا في كل بلاد العالم يعني الواحد لما يكون عنده عمليه دقيقه في شيء معين يبحث عن الدكتور اللي متخصص في هذه العمليه لكن بصوره عامه اكثر من 98% من العمليات والاحتياجات ما تؤدى محليا تفضل آخر سؤال في الصالة هنا.
Yes. فايك المطيري Institute of Public Administration. In the new health system that was enacted in 1423 in Hijri calendar, it's saying that the Ministry of Health can sell their entities to the private sector. My question, is there a plan for something like that, for renting or chasing health or Ministry of Health facilities? And the second question, do you think that we need a specialized court in health care services that deal with the problems problems from the side of government or private hospitals, public hospitals, patients, and insurance companies, instead of putting all the things on the Council of Cooperative Health Insurance or Ministry of Health? Thank you.
Lindsay.
Okay, I think in response to that, generally in response to that, the World Bank's position is that in countries pursuing the kinds of reforms and changes that Saudi Arabia is contemplating at the moment, we're recommending that there's a genetic set of enabling environment activities, which I think may cover some of what you're talking about. That is the Ministry of Health increasing its capacity in policy making, in planning, deciding upon its own role as a regulator, as a policy setter, as a standard maker, looking at the human capital investments that would be required for a ministry, not only a Ministry of Health, but Ministry of Finance, and this country, the Ministry of the Civil Service, for example, that would need to be made in order to deal with the kinds of issues that you're talking about, and also to review the structures that would be required in terms of dealing with the systemic issues that arise as a result of any change in the system, whether the, in this case regarding your question, whether the Insurance Council is it's fair to let them deal with all the issues, or whether there needs to be a counterpart agency to, as a foil to deal with them, or whether the capacity can be developed within the ministry itself to deal with that. The second dimension in our advice is that foundation activities need to be undertaken in hospitals. And again, this is independent of whichever model a country like Saudi Arabia may choose to pursue. Even if it doesn't pursue private sector participation on a large scale, that includes, again, investment in hospital human capital, which may answer Dr. Baderia's question from earlier on in the question period. It includes the obvious things mentioned, development of health management information systems, and a huge investment in the management skills of people directing government hospitals. Also inventory of stock and capital, financial management and so forth.
Yeah, thank you. الحقيقة في هنالك يعني سخن النقاش لكن الوقت احنا تجاوزناه بخمس دقائق في الختام أود أن أشكركم على حضوركم وعلى مشاركتكم الإيجابية والفعالة وأشكر الأخوة المحاضرين والمتحدثين وأشكر مستشفى الملك فيصل التخصصي على تنظيمه لهذه الندوة شكرا لكم وإلى اللقاء في ندوات قادمة شكرا
السلام عليكم Just a reminder and announcement tonight at 8 o'clock there is going to be a workshop by the organized by Saudi Arabian General Investment Authority SAGIA for under the title of the future strategy in health economic from the aspect of the investment there will be lectures under the title for SWOT analysis for the investment in Saudi health care sector there will be dinner included as well it will start at 8 o'clock and will finish at 10 o'clock I advise you to come it's free of charge and I appreciate your attendance thank you very much